Dear friends, I am Dr. Amrit G. Kumar. I am working as Associate Professor in the School of Education of Central University of Kerala. Today, I welcome all of you to the NIOS studio. Today, we will be discussing about Geometry and Conference. Geometry and Conference was held in 1990 in Thailand. Geometrian is the name of a place in Thailand. This conference is known for a proclamation. The name of the proclamation is Education for All. This conference was held from 5th to 9th March 1990, and it was attended by 155 member states of United Nations. And this Geometrian conference, which I told you already, is known for World Declaration on Education for All, Meeting Basic Learning Needs. This was actually the title of that particular conference. So the essence of World Conference on Education for All and the Declaration on Education for All is very important. We all must know about this essence of this World Declaration on Education for All. According to this particular declaration, which has happened in Geometrian in 1990, as I told you earlier, World Declaration on Education for All provides the following thing. It proposes that education is a fundamental right for all people of all ages throughout our world. And also it said, education is really meant to ensure safer, healthier, more prosperous and environmentally sound world. It said, education is an indispensable key to condition for personal and social improvement. Also, it said, identification of the value of traditional knowledge and indigenous cultural heritage for development and prosperous society. Education for All, or I would call it as EFA in short form, provides provisions or advocated provisions for more relevant and qualitatively improved and universally available education. It also proposes or advocates for understanding basic education as a fundamental to the strengthening of higher levels of education and scientific and technological literacy and capacity, and thus to self-sufficient development. Now let us look into the thrust areas of Geometrian Conference. There were actually 9 articles drafted according to the purpose, expanded vision, commitment and requirements for Education for All in the World Declaration on Education 1990. These 9 articles are the thrust or the core areas of Geometrian Conference. Let us discuss each of them in detail. Article 1 of Geometrian Conference is known as Meeting Basic Learning Needs. This particular article emphasizes the importance to individual needs in education. And second, it emphasized cultural, linguistic and spiritual heritage and possibilities for empowering the individual through cultural, linguistic and spiritual heritage. Also, Meeting Basic Learning Needs emphasize transmission of the cultural and oral values to promote sense of identity and providing a worthy feeling for it. Article 2 talks about shaping the vision. It proposes for a growing world beyond the contemporary situations through the tool of education. So we all have to grow beyond the present to a future. Also, it proposes an expanded vision of access and equity, focus on learning, broadening means and scope of education, enhancing the environment for learning, strengthening partnerships. Article 3 of Education for All Declaration passed in the Geometrian Conference discuss about universalizing access and promoting equity. This means that quality and equity in education has to be improved across the world. Also, it emphasized education of girl children and women, which was an important issue that the whole global society has to address immediately. Reducing disparities in education is another important area which was discussed under this Article 3. Also, it emphasized another important deprived group of our society, that is disabled. So, this particular article provides opportunity for the education of the disabled women and people who are suffering from poor educational facilities and so on. In fact, this article looks at the people who are deprived. Article 4 of Education for All Declaration is on focusing on learning. Article 4, focus on learning. This particular article focuses on basic education and actual learning acquisition and outcomes. As we all think, education is a process, and at the same time, this process has a wonderful outcome. And this outcome must be useful for the society. So this particular article emphasizes the outcome of education and the benefit of this outcome for the betterment of the future society. Article 5 discusses about broadening the means and scope of basic education. According to this article, all available instruments and channels of information, communication, and social action could be used to help convey essential knowledge and inform and educate people on social issues. So, this particular article emphasizes the use of technology and various modes of communications and various channels of communication for imparting education to our society. Article 6 talks about enhancing the learning environment for learning. Learning environment includes physical and emotional and of course social as well. So it involves empowering physical and emotional support for education, which certainly involve empowering the adult society who are the key to provide a better environment for education to the younger generation of our society. So adult learning has become an important priority of this particular article for providing a wonderful environment for our future generation to get educated. Article 7 of Geometrian Conference's famous proclamation of Education for All focuses on strengthening partnership. According to this particular article, we have to combine the efforts of national, regional and local educational authorities to improve the quality and access of education. So, it emphasized need for a new and revitalized partnerships at all levels. All levels means starting from national to state level, local level and even further. So, a proper communication between all these levels are very essential for a system to perform a wonderful education system. Article 8 of Education for All Declaration is on developing a supportive policy context. As we all know, policy is an important tool for empowering the system of education in any country. Not only in countries, regional and local level, we need supporting policies to have quality education. So policies cannot be confined only to education, because education is not independent in itself. Education in modern day is connected to economic, labor, health and several other areas. So, a proper policy support should be obtained from all these different dimensions of our nation. So this particular article emphasizes for a suitable economic, trade, labor, employment, and health policies which will enhance learners' incentives and contributions to societal development. You may be wondering why trade, labor, and all this. Of course, we need the support of the labor forces like our teachers. To have better quality education, we need a better quality teacher, a society of teachers, a community of teachers, and their trade demands and their trade needs should be protected. Their labor demands should be protected. And in all this way, and also trade is important because the students who complete their education has to be absorbed by the society through its business, trade, and all these particular areas. So a proper policy for supporting all this is very essential. Article 9 emphasizes upon mobilizing resources. We know resource crunch is an important issue in education in all over the world. Even the developed nations are facing the crunch of fund for educating their younger generation. So India also has to look into that particular issue. So Education for All declaration proposes mobilizing existing and new financial resources from public, private, and of course even from voluntary organizations who are ready to support the cause of education. So it is from the realization that only government funding would not be sufficient enough to support the mission and vision of education for all in our society. We have discussed 9 articles of Education for All. Now we will be looking at how this Education for All declaration has improved, has affected on various dimensions of our society. First and foremost thing is that this particular declaration on Education for All has resulted in strengthening an international solidarity. Meeting basic learning needs constitutes a common and universal human responsibility. It requires international solidarity and equitable and fair economic relations in order to redress existing economic disparities. All nations have valuable knowledge and experiences to share for designing effective educational policies and programs. So, what we need to improve the existing education system and to improve the access and equity in the education system is an international solidarity. So, in addition to the 9 articles proposed by Education for All declaration, it has proposed a framework of action to meet its basic visions. There were 6 main areas of action which was listed in the Declaration on Education for All. They are, first one, early childhood care and development. Second one, universal access to and completion of primary education. Third one, improvement in learning achievement. Fourth one, adult literacy. Fifth one, skill training for youth and adults. Sixth one, knowledge, skills, and values for better living by individuals and families. From this framework of action, it is very clear that the Declaration for Education for All will focus on this particular 6 main areas to consummate its vision proposed in it. Let us look into the basic principles for action plan of Education for All declaration. Let us discuss the basic principles for action plan of Education for All declaration. The basic principles of Education for All declaration are equity, emphasis on learning, broadening of the meaning and scope of basic education, improvement in the learning environment, strengthening of partnership. As we all know, equity is an important issue that we face in our education system. Everybody should have the opportunity to get education without having any discrimination on their caste, creed, and on any other kind of categorization. Also, all kind of education system should emphasize on learning rather than just attracting students into the school. School should ensure learning also. And of course, we all know the scope of basic education has to grow from just learning 3 R's, reading, writing, and arithmetic. And for improving this and then growing, then allowing or broadening of the meaning of scope of basic education, we need to strengthen the learning environment. And for this strengthening of the learning environment, we need, of course, the support of strengthening of partnerships from across the society. Now let us look into the major goals and targets of Education for All Declaration. The major goals and targets of Education for All Declaration includes universal access to the major goals and targets of Education for All Declaration includes universal access to and 80% completion rate in primary education by 2000. As we all know, this Education for All Declaration was made on 1990s. So it has given 20 years of gap to achieve this 80% completion rate in primary education. Second goal was the reduction in adult literacy rate to half by 2000 with special emphasis on female literacy. As we have seen in its basic mission and goal, it is repeating two important points that the global society has to attain. The first one is adult literacy and the second one is female literacy. Adult literacy and female literacy, adult illiteracy and female illiteracy are so huge in the third world nations. So this has to be reduced to the half by 2000 is an important goal of Education for All Declaration. Another important goal which was proposed by Education for All Declaration is improvement in learning achievement. So the learning achievement has to be improved globally. And the next one was expansion of early childhood care and development activities, including family and community interventions, especially for the poor, disabled, and the disadvantaged children. We know primary education and elementary education starts in our nation by the age of 5 years. If the student joins a school by the age of 5 years, till 5 years, the child is not being educated in most of the deprived societies. Most of the societies. In the rural society, we don't have any provision for educating the children before 5 years of age. But it should be noted that every children has an educatable period of time after 3 years of their birth. So a fruitful period, that means 3 to 5 years, has to be handled effectively to mold our small children, to equip them for primary education. So this has been given priority as an important goal of Education for All. Now let us look into the impact of Jamaican Conference and the Education for All Declaration. The main contribution of Jamaican Conference lies in its influence on national governments and their policies, plans and programs. As we have already discussed, 155 nations, member nations of United Nations, attended the Jamaican Conference in 1990. They all have signed in the Declaration of Education for All. And it has certainly influenced all these governments to take up policies or to frame policies so as to ensure education for all in their own nations. And we all know India also did it. We know education for all has been already included in our constitution by Article 45 as a directive principle. In 1995, it has been the parliament has passed a bill on converting education as a fundamental right. But due to a clause which was included in that particular bill, the passing of the education as a fundamental right or inclusion of education as a fundamental right was delayed up to 2009. And in 2010, we have passed our Right to Education Bill and thereby made education as a fundamental right of every Indian citizen who is below 14 years of age. The Jomitian Conference in that way was a great success, not only in India, but almost all the 155 nations who participated in that particular conference. The Jomitian Conference influenced the policies and programs of the national governments across the members of the nations. Impact of Jomitian Conference on E9 countries is very significant. But before that, we should know what is this E9 countries. You know, the high population countries comprising Bangladesh, Brazil, China, Egypt, India, Indonesia, Mexico, Nigeria, and Pakistan has more than 50% of the world's population. And all these 9 nations I listed just now are called as E9 countries. These countries' basic characteristic and feature is that all these countries are highly populated. All the E9 countries assembled in Recife, Brazil from 31st January to 2nd February 2000. They reviewed the progress of education for all declaration in their own countries. It was a very fruitful discussion. This was a very fruitful discussion. It was found that all the nations has improved considerably in improving their education as a compulsory and free. These nations assessed that all these E9 nations were successful in implementing the different provisions of Education for All Declaration in their nations. Their nations have gone far ahead from 1990 when they reviewed their progress in 2000, which was a prosperous signal. Let us see the impact of Education for All Declaration on South Asian region. Now let us look into the effect or the impact of Jomitian Conference on South Asian nations. The South Asian nations include Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Maldives, Nepal, Pakistan, Afghanistan, and Sri Lanka. It is reported that these nations has improved considerably in primary school enrollment, early childhood care and education programs, in quality in their education, functional adult literacy, educational management information systems, and they all have increased their national budgets for basic education also. And in spite of all this, there is a lot of achievement still to be attained. Now let us look into what we have discussed today. We were talking about Jomitian Conference, which was held in 1990 at Thailand. This conference take up the major issue of education for all, and later on it has passed a very famous declaration which was signed by 155 UN member nations. The declaration was known as Education for All Declaration. This declaration was having 9 articles. We have discussed all these 9 articles in detail. And in addition to these 9 articles, we have looked into the mission and goals of Education for All Declaration. Also, we have reviewed Also, we have discussed the impact of Jomitian conference on E9 nations and on South Asian region, South Asian nations. Also, we have seen that Jomitian conference has been a great success in ensuring education for all, for the people across the world. The thrust area of the Jomitian conference, as we have seen, has emphasized education of the people who are deprived. Education for all has been so special and has to be mentioned and will be remembered forever for its emphasis on free and compulsory education for all the children, and also for its emphasis on women education, education of the physically disabled. It is so special for its provisions for education for women, education for the disabled, and its attempts to overcome the disparities of education. I hope that you have understood the purpose and various thrust areas and articles of Jomitian Conference. I am so thankful to all of you for your patient listening, and hope you will be able to discuss and you will be able to reflect upon this particular idea of education for all and the declaration which was based on this wonderful idea. Thank you all.
प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने
हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने जीवन ये प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय की लोच से युक्त हो
कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय की लोच से युक्त हो
मित्रों हम उठे और जागे
मंजिल आने की ध्वनि सुने हम अपना जीवन स्वयं बने हम अपना
जीवन ये प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने
मिलता फिर बनिया में इसके